Hey, what's up, you guys? Ivan slash Vaporterra here. So, for this video, I thought we'd take a look at a jersey that I'm not going to be wearing for the next few months. Probably because, you know what happened. USA failed to qualify for the World Cup 2018 Russia. I'm not a Caps fan, so I'm not going to be burning this jersey. But, I mean, it's a nice jersey still. Like, even when I'm disappointed in the U.S. men's national team, it's a nice jersey, I admit it. I mean, of course it's a nice jersey, otherwise I wouldn't have it. But anyway, I just wanted to give a few minutes for my thoughts concerning the result and what this means for the next at least 4 to 5 years, probably even longer for the future of the sport in this country. And before we continue on, for anyone not from a country that calls it soccer, I'm sorry, I'm calling it soccer. You know I mean football or football, but I'm going to call it soccer. If you don't like it, get over it or stop watching. So this is the first time since 1986, obviously this is the first time in my lifetime that the USA will miss out on the World Cup. It's a huge deal. Like, we don't even, like, we haven't even processed it or before it happened, what it would be like for USA to miss out on the World Cup. And I think, you know, it's both a good thing and a bad thing. We kind of just expected it to happen. And this whole time, like, throughout the hex, USA underperforming, dropping points in games that they should have won or drawn. Those wins became draws, those draws became losses, and we were playing with fire. And you know what happens when you play with fire? You get burned. But at the same time, I think the media, the players, the fans, we were kind of just telling ourselves, it'll be all right, you know? It always is, right? But this isn't a movie. This is real life. And this is what happens when you don't see things coming. The impossible happens. I mean, not impossible because it happened, but you get the idea. This is going to be a pretty rambly video because I'm still pretty pissed at what happened last night, so I'm just going to say my thoughts. I think everyone involved in U.S. soccer tragically underestimated Trinidad and Tobago. Like, even someone like me, you know, I do my homework about the national teams, the club teams, the players, the clubs they play for, how good and bad they performed. And I thought, you know, anything can happen, but it's lining up in our favor. USA, we had pretty much everyone we wanted in the squad, except for the injured John Brooks. Fabian Johnson, questionable. That is still a big decision to leave him off the roster. But I don't see him changing the result either way. Considering that we conceded 13 goals, despite all the goals we did score, losing John Brooks was definitely the bigger change than leaving Fabian Johnson off the roster. Anyway, so USA just need a win against Trinidad and Tobago to qualify automatically. A draw would have been almost as good in qualifying us automatically. If Honduras or Panama won and we didn't win, if we lost, then there was a chance that we would get into the fourth place finish in the hexagonal, which would have meant a playoff match home and away against Australia. But what happened was Honduras and Panama both won. Not only did they both win, they won against the strongest teams in the region, Mexico and Costa Rica. Granted, both of them already locked up qualifying before this match day. So, Mexico and Costa Rica, it didn't matter if they won, lost, or drew. They were going to the World Cup regardless. However, both those teams, Mexico and Costa Rica, they still played strong lineups. They weren't trying to throw the towel to get USA eliminated. I don't think any team anymore would do that. We know about the Germany and Austria situation in the, I believe it was 1992 World Cup in Spain, where they you know, conspired to get a certain result so they would both go through and Algeria was eliminated. But ever since then, they've been really cracking down that, and I don't think any national team would do that. And we saw this earlier with this cycle. Brazil, they beat up Chile pretty bad. They knew that if they beat Chile, there was a good chance Argentina would go to the World Cup. And there's a lot of Brazilian fans, including one of my friends, who's like, I'm okay if Brazil loses if Argentina misses out. But nonetheless, Brazil still played to the best of their ability, even though they were already qualified in South America. And they didn't care if Argentina went in or not. They played the game. And that's exactly what Mexico and Costa Rica did. It looks bad now because we needed them to beat Panama and Honduras, and they didn't. But even if they did or didn't try their best, that's irrelevant. Mexico is supposed to care about Mexico's team. Costa Rica is supposed to care about Costa Rica's team. They don't care about the USA's team, win or lose. USA had the chance to save themselves, and they didn't. They let in two goals. One was an own goal from Omar Gonzalez. So, as unfair as that may sound, Omar Gonzalez is getting the most blame of anyone, at least the players, for this result. If that was like the worst own goal I've seen. Like, it was a great goal if you're Trinidad and Tobago, but he won up the Swiss defender, Johan de Giroux, who scored a pretty bad own goal earlier in qualifying for the European region. But at least Johan de Giroux and Switzerland, they still have a chance to qualify. This own goal essentially took our chances away. And then they score a second goal, Trinidad and Tobago, from Alvin Jones. It was a pretty good goal, but from 30 yards out, the defending was very suspect. Christian Pulisic gave us hope. Clint Dempsey hit the post. We were close, but close doesn't count for crap, because we're out of the World Cup. This is already kind of becoming a longer video than I was hoping, so I'll just wrap up my final thoughts and what I hope will happen in the next few years and next year when we're watching the World Cup. So for me personally, this is not going to be too bad because I'll still have Mexico to root for, but this is still really bad. I mean, I'm Mexican-American, so I know Mexico and USA are rivals, but both those countries are part of my heritage and culture, so I'm going to respect and root for both nations. If you have a problem with that, too bad. So there's still Mexico, but for Americans who only root for the United States, there's still a lot of reason to watch the World Cup. You're still going to have most of the biggest stars there. Lionel Messi, Cristiano Ronaldo, Sergio Ramos, Harry Kane. I know I'm missing a few, but I don't want to name everybody. Antoine Griezmann, Paul Pogba. Okay, that's enough names. There's still going to be a lot of good players. Oh, Robert Lewandowski. Okay, now enough names. Stop rambling. And this is still going to be a good sport to watch. A lot of other nations around the world, they have to deal with their countries not making the World Cup. It's Netherlands and Chile among the biggest ones for this cycle that are missing out on the World Cup. But they still watch it. They still support the World Cup because it is the biggest sporting event in the world. Bigger than the Olympics, bigger than the Super Bowl, bigger than any playoff or championship in any league. Bigger than the Rugby World Cup, obviously, goes without saying. This is still going to be a great World Cup with a lot of good players and teams. Hopefully some drama and excitement as well. Still support your domestic leagues wherever you are in the world. This is especially important for the USA right now. Major League Soccer is going to be home to the most important matches we're going to see in the next few months. We're going to have the last few MLS regular season games coming up, the MLS playoffs coming up. The new MLS season is going to start and probably end before USA plays another meaningful international match in the 2019 Gold Cup. Unless there's some sort of qualifiers or something that start before then. But I doubt it because USA is still very highly seeded. So this sucks. This is an embarrassment for US soccer, but it's up to us, the fans, to keep this sport going. we're not going to let all this progress in making soccer a well-supported sport in this country go to waste. We're going to still support the teams we support, both club and international. And hopefully things will change in a systemic level that will allow USA for new long-term success. I can go on about this, but boy, anything else I could say has already been said. So let me know your thoughts below on the USA's failure to qualify for the World Cup. And yeah, hopefully this will be a one-time thing and USA will get back to business in 2022. But for now, we're going to have to enjoy the World Cup without the United States.